Hey everybody, Jim Chester here. We're coming to you live from the CBP 41st Annual Conference down here in Scottsdale, Arizona. I have Fred DiDomenico with me right here. Welcome to the show, Fred.
Thanks. We've done a bunch of podcasts and things together, man, and I love your passion and purpose for chiropractic, especially corrective care and CBP.
Dude, I love CBP, and that's our first topic. Let's talk a little bit about CBP and why it's so necessary for this group to be in chiropractic.
Well, the principle of chiropractic is subluxation causes disease and even early death. There's tons of research that already proved that. It's the principle. And I know that this is the most advanced science ever in the whole history of the profession. I mean, Deed's the most highly researched, acclaimed chiropractor, and he's, you know, publishes even in medical journals, you know, of how now a truly a subluxated spine and posture causes disease and even early death. I mean, these are medical studies. So at what point as a profession do we take responsibility and say we detect, correct, and eliminate? there's a big word, man. That's the bridge. We eliminate subluxations for humanity. How about that one?
I love it, dude. And the passion with this guy, we kind of bounce off each other really well because we both see the world quite similar. Yeah. Like I was interviewing you last time, and we were like living off each other's sentences. Yeah. So it works really well when we have the similar flow state of what we both really believe in, and that's supporting the beautiful profession of chiropractic. But not only that, creating a culture. So I know right. One of the things that we're going to discuss today is talking about culture. And let's talk about that idea of culture that you're starting to manifest.
Well, we just live in a different world now. I mean, the old business model of management by numbers, it's already obsolete, right? I mean, look at Apple, most valuable. It's the most profitable culture. Companies are building cultures. Chiropractic is a culture. A culture is an organization, a group of people that have a certain belief system that inspires behavior. Right? Look at chiropractic. The principle is truth, man. Yet some people say, well, they believe it or they don't believe it. And even in the whole profession, you know, well, I think Nate put a cervical kyphosis in there. Well, you're right, but that doesn't mean it's not going to create disease, and it doesn't mean we can't correct it. So, you know, when you create a culture, there's a difference between building a practice and building a culture. Because a practice can have a number of different mindsets. Hey, you have people that walk out on day two. You have people that only want to use their insurance. You have people that may go through correction. You have some that go in a lifetime. You have some that come and go when they're in pain. And you end up with 8 or 9 different mindsets. That's a practice, and that fractures your practice from the inside out. A culture has one belief system, lifetime care. So I use a metaphor. I'm going to talk today. I'm using a metaphor of a vault. You know, you have to know that code. And once you open the door, okay, that's patient community care. But then there's a second door. Man, they continue with care, right? They go through a second phase of correction. And then there's a third door, lifetime care. And they all have different codes, right? So are you going to know 3 codes? But here's the key to a culture. The third code works for all 3. So if I just know the lifetime code, then when a new patient walks in, I can move through all 3 vaults. Into lifetime care, and that's a lifetime culture. So the question is, do you want 8 out of 10 of people that walk through your front door to end up in lifetime care? And that's where I'm going to show how to do that. 21 years of studying human behavior, being immersed in human behavior. It's a system, man. Know the code of the third door, and almost all 80% walk through all 3.
And that's a really cool thing. When I met Dr. Fred, it was 10 years ago in the Las Vegas, Nevada. We were at a seminar together for chiropractic biophysics. Yeah. And when I saw you, you gave me this amazing handshake. You looked me right in my eye. You received me. You had no idea who I was, but you taught me a couple things about human behavior that no one else had ever taught me before. When you receive somebody, give them your attention, right. Treat them very well, and then you'll make a lasting impression on that person. And what is that? That's a culture. So you were training me in culture 10 years ago when I was just this guy that was running around shooting videos and thinking that I was doing something really special, which I was. Sure. But when I was doing it, I didn't realize the impact of the people that were inside of this culture that I was actually building relationships with.
Right.
So now we're here 10 years later. I just celebrated my 10th year of working in chiropractic like 2 weekends ago. Awesome. So now it's been 10 years of being in some facet with this beautiful profession and building a culture of our own now.
Right.
So that's really cool. As we come up on the edge of our interview today, is there anybody out there you'd like to say hi to?
Well, first of all, I mean, obviously all the elite people and all the CB people, but most importantly, all the spinal corrective docs and all the doctors, whether you do spinal correction or not, is let's detect, correct, and eliminate. Let's make a difference in humanity. Chiropractic is a message for humanity. Let's raise our responsibility and let's find the best way that we can actually eliminate subluxated humanity. Isn't that why we're here in this life? And you know what? What if we can do it in our lifetime? So I'm saying hello to everybody out there and say, let's raise the bar on what we're doing in chiropractic and raise the message and be congruent with the principle and the application of what I believe to be the best message for humanity that God gave us.
Amen, brother. I just want to say a big thank you to Deed Harrison for having us out here to the 41st Annual for Chiropractic Biophysics. If you guys want more information on what Deed is doing, go to idealspine.com. There's a port of entry for everybody, whether you're a practicing chiropractor or you're looking for a patient portal. It's a pretty amazing program. What if people want to work with you? What does that look like?
Oh, man, we have a one-on-one coaching system. I mean, really what it is, the bottom line is you tell me what your vision is and we'll do everything to create it. So we don't stuff people in a box. We help you create your own box. And when you learn to build a culture, then your practice runs on its own. Not only will you have 8 out of 10 becoming lifetime patients, but it has its own life force. You can actually have freedom. For the first 11 years I practiced, I was a prisoner to my purpose. And when I learned, all other coaching systems were teaching me how to build a practice. And when I learned how to build a culture, not only do we fulfill our purpose on a higher level, but I actually had freedom. I could take a vacation. Isn't that interesting?
I think that that's what doctors deserve. And I think that's what the chiropractic industry deserves, is they deserve a better quality lifestyle for the practicing chiropractor, to where that they can have freedom for life and their relationships and their responsibilities for their community. And they can maybe take a vacation.
Yeah, there you go. That helps. That helps.
So if you guys want to find out more what we're doing, go to ChiroHustle.com, listen to episode 100, and you can hear Luke and I interview each other so you can see who the guys behind the screen actually are. At this point in the interview, is there anything I didn't ask you that you'd like to share with our audience today?
You know, I just think coming from a spiritually grounded basis, that if you're a chiropractor, this is our sole purpose, S-O-U-L. And our greatest fear should be not fulfilling that sole purpose in this lifetime. So whatever you need to do, whatever your vision is spirit seeking manifestation, that you know you're responsible and you feel it right here, regardless of your success. If you're not fulfilling your vision, you feel that void, just do whatever it takes. Whatever it takes to fulfill it. Because not only is there another step probably waiting for you, but the amount of lives that you will impact will be even greater than it is now.
Awesome, brother. Well, we're at the edge of our interview, so I'm going to say a couple more things to you guys. If you're watching this right now, hit the share button. If you love this message, hit the heart button for us. And if you're watching this on replay, hashtag replay in the comments there. And if you got some value, hashtag value in the comments there. I'm going to give this man a big hug.
Thanks, brother. Always great being with you.
Yeah, man. And I'm going to go and close out by telling you guys are just one story away. Keep hustling. We'll see you guys on the next one.